So we're here driving back from Vegas. Robert Garcia, one of the best trainers in the world. Pita, are you knocked out or are you okay? Who's in the back?
Eddie.
Eddie, are you awake or sleeping? He's, yeah, 21 years old at the time of his life, hanging out with Mayweather.
He just turned 21 last Sunday. So, yeah, hanging out with Floyd.
Experiencing Vegas like an adult.
And you know what? It was cool that, you know, we were walking around and Floyd was cool enough to, you know, walk with him, have a conversation, put his hand around him and everything. That was pretty cool, man. I seen that and I was like, that tells you a lot about a person. You know, instead he could have had his securities. Oh, can you please step away? Can you please walk in, you know, on the other side or whatever?
He doesn't know him. He's a kid. Exactly. He's 21.
Of course, you know. He didn't, you know, he was with us, and so that's why he was okay. But he doesn't really know him. What if he was just one of those, you know, a lot of guys just show up and want to hang out?
Yeah, what if it was a fuck-up?
Yeah, that was cool.
So we went on Twitter at Garcia Boxing. We asked people, did they have questions for you, Robert? And the morning after your meeting with Floyd Mayweather, a lot of questions. First of all, first question, why did Chavez Jr. go with Freddie?
Chavez Jr. lives very close by to the gym in to Wild Card, 15-minute drive. You know, and I guess for right now, he didn't really want to be driving to Riverside. So, and right now with that, I'm so busy with Mikey and Abner Mares, and of course a lot of our younger guys. But I can't be, you know, it was going to be very hard for me to be going somewhere else to train Julio, you know. Last month when we were in Big Ritz, because we still didn't know what was going to happen with Mikey, we still didn't have a date for Mikey. Abner was not in training camp, so I was able to do it, but I can't do that anymore. But you know, he's got his reasons, you know. He's still cool with me, you know. We talked, and he's very cool. So
he's a friend of yours.
No, he's still our friend. He's still my friend. So you know, I'm not mad at him, you know. He's cool, you know, and I know Freddie's also a great trainer, so why be mad?
Next question, is McGregor Mayweather going to happen?
Well, I guess now it's all up to Mayweather. Mayweather's talking about it like if it will happen, so I'm sure it's up to Mayweather, because McGregor will probably do it in a heartbeat. Why not? You know, make a nice payday he's never made before. So, of course he would. But as of now, you know, or as of what we've heard and everybody else heard him saying, that it looks like that's what he's looking for. You know, he's looking at doing that fight.
A similar question: is Floyd serious about the McGregor fight?
Well, he said he was. He says he wants it.
That's the one fight that he wanted.
Yeah, that's the fight he wants. And it looks like, you know, they might be already been planning out on a date and everything. So it's interesting, you know. It's interesting to know or to see that he's looking into that fight.
All right, here's a smart ass question. Prime for prime, who wins? Robert Garcia versus Mikey Garcia? Mikey's not here to defend himself.
Yeah, like well, what can I say? It would have been easy fight for me.
Pita, who wins, Robert or Mikey in their prime?
Easy fight.
Both in their prime?
Yeah.
I don't know. Tell you, easy fight for me, man.
Mayweather said yesterday you were a dangerous fighter.
Easy fight for me, man.
They asked him, how come you never fought Robert? You're both champions at the same time. He said, are you crazy? Next question. How many tequila shots have you had in one night? I guess in general, what's the most you've ever had?
I don't do tequila, so I probably had a few shots of tequila with friends just to be part of the group and everybody's doing it, but just like one or two max. I can't do tequila anyway, so I've done more vodka than tequila, and that, you know, we've got pretty wasted a few times on vodka.
We have all these Russian fighters. You have to learn how to take shots.
Yeah.
What weight class, what weight division does Mikey Garcia come back at?
I think the plan is to get him back, you know, for first fight back, is going to be at 140 because of all, you know, the 2 years that he's been off. but then we're gonna get down to 135 to go after a title. We want a title 135.
Does Neno Rodriguez beat Verdejo in the future?
Look, it's a fight that could happen and more likely will happen if they both continue to win and look good and impress and, you know, get a fan base. Of course, one day, you know, that's what this business is all about. You know, make the big fights, make the money fights. Neno is looking really good, has made some nice statements when he goes out and knocks his opponents cold. Verdejo is a superstar in Puerto Rico, so they could build that fight up, you know. But it wouldn't happen anytime soon. It'll happen in the future. But, yeah, it's a fight that could happen, of course. And can Neno beat him? Hey, you know, if we're saying 2 years from now, a big, nice event, you know, maybe even a pay-per-view because of Verdejo and Neno keeps winning, you know, Neno has the power to knock anybody out. So can he? Of course he can.
Yesterday I asked Floyd Mayweather, Floyd, Robert's a great trainer. What happens if Conor McGregor calls Robert Garcia and says, train me? And Floyd said he better fucking train him. So here's a question saying, if Robert Garcia was going to train McGregor to box Mayweather, what would be the game plan?
Yeah, it's really hard, you know, to have a game plan against Mayweather. But, you know, being that I don't know McGregor very well. I don't know him at all, I guess. You know, I just seen him tap out in his last fight, you know, because I didn't see the fight.
Yeah.
My kids were talking about it, so they showed me whatever.
The highlight, yeah.
So I don't really know him, but if he's, you know, he's a MMA fighter. You know, he's a tough guy. So maybe fight tough, like a Maidana type, like Maidana fight Mayweather type of fight. But
we don't know if he has.
But yeah,
that ability.
But see, the things that the skills are, it would be very hard, very hard.
Here's a question: has Floyd Mayweather changed his opinion on you now that you're negotiating? Now that he's negotiated with Mikey, as if in the past, you know.
Look, it was just, well, the promotion for the Maidana fight, of course.
Great promotion.
We, you know, and we really meant, you know, it's not like I didn't mean it. You know, he started off, you know, with a little bit of bad mouthing, so we did the same, and, you know.
It sold the fight.
And, you know, it's not like we planned it out, but it is part of, you know, selling an event, you know. What I said, I meant, but or what he said, I'm sure he meant also. But it, you know, it's things that happened a couple years ago, and you know, one thing when we sat right there next ringside and next to him in the fights, Mikey heard everything. Mikey heard everything. He shook my hand. He's like, look, Robert, if in the past promotions that we had against each other, I offended you, or you felt you took something personal, I apologize. It was part of the event. It was part of at that moment. You know, we were promoting a fight. We were going against each other. He's like, no hard feelings. I, you know, shook my hand. I'm telling you, and said, if I offended you, if I made you or your team feel bad, I apologize. He was man enough to say that. You know, that shows respect from a person.
But also, Robert, nothing offends you guys. Your team, no, but I'm saying it doesn't matter what anybody says. Your attitude is like, you fuck it. We move forward. But the fact that he said, because he didn't know that.
That's classy. You know, I'm not one of those guys that now, because of that,
you're going to hold a grudge.
I'm
going to
hold a grudge. Fuck it, my whole life, I'm gonna say, go now, fuck Mayweather. No, that's stupid. You know, I also understand the business. I also know the business, but I also understand that you know, when a fighter has accomplished and done so much, I even if we go against them, I got to admit, you know, I got to be, you know, reasonable and know reality. You know, we've had differences with Roach, but come on, as a trainer, he's a great trainer. You know what I mean? Things like that. You know, I can't hate Pacquiao because he beat two of my fighters. Hells no, can't do that.
Yeah, but you've always said Mayweather's a great fighter. You and Mikey, and it's Mikey's favorite fighter. He always has been.
He's a great fighter.
And I remember years ago I would ask Mikey.
Favorite fighter.
Yeah. He always said Floyd Mayweather, even when it wasn't the popular answer.
Yeah. I think Sugar Leonard is my favorite fighter.
Because you grew up watching him. Yeah. But the new generation grew up watching Floyd, the money, the flashy, the undefeated, the shoulder roll.
You're right.
I'm sure without Mayweather, no one would mention shoulder roll. No. Defense.
It's true.
Here's a question for you. America versus Chivas.
Fuck.
Is it going down this weekend?
Tomorrow.
Really? Are you going to watch it?
It already, they did the first game. What was it? Tuesday? Wednesday?
Vita.
Or Thursday?
I think so.
Yeah.
They tied, we have a soccer player in the car.
They tied 0-0.
College soccer player.
He's a college soccer player right there. He plays for Merced.
So break down the fight. Break down the game. So who are you going for, first of all?
America, of course.
Why?
100%. Because that's my team.
Everybody likes Chivas, though, Robert.
All the Mexicans like Chivas, and I consider myself Mexican, but there's a lot of Mexicans that like America too. It depends on what you like about each team and their the players that they bring. You know, America brings guys from all over the world. You know, really good players. They have a great program. They have a lot of money, you know. But it just, when I started, you know, following soccer, my Wapita, you know, at 5 years old playing soccer, you know, that's the team that fucking caught my attention, and that's the team that I wanted to go for.
Who's their biggest star right now?
Right now, he got a red card.
Why? Oh, so he's out of the next game?
So he can't play the next game. ¿Cómo se llama?
Sambuesa.
He
got Brazilian guy?
Argentinian, maybe? I don't even know. Chileno? I don't even know. The thing is that
Did he earn it? Was he dirty?
It was the second one was questionable, but it was the second yellow, so they had to give him red.
That fucks up the whole team.
Yeah, and so they played with one guy less for like 15, 20 minutes, huh? Yeah, 20 some minutes, huh? Let me get this card.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Ellie Secback.